Hi everyone, back with another update. Just about done painting the boat. So getting pretty excited, but I want to pause and make a video and show you guys the progress so far. So just have one last top coat to do on the inside of the boat, and really just wanted to summarize the process so far. So as you can see, there's the outside that's done more or less. I've got the ocean blue with the white stripe accent, and essentially I had the boat flipped over up on sawhorses, and I used a roller and brush on the outside. Tried to do the same thing on the inside, and it just took so much longer. As you can imagine, rolling the outside was easy because it's just a flat, easy to access surfaces. Getting on the inside, there's just all these nooks and crannies, and hand painted one primer coat on the inside with the help from my wife, and it took about 4 hours, and that just it was really painful, and I wouldn't advise it. So I borrowed a sprayer from my neighbor. He has this mini mite for platinum, which is a really nice sprayer, and you see the sprayer here, and so I'll talk about that a little bit more. But what I used was the Interlux primer with an Interlux bright side top coat, and the outside is ocean blue with the blue glow white. The inside is all just blue glow white. So what I did was just use a regular roller, and I started with the primer on the outside using a standard roller, quarter inch nap with the fibrous nap, and that worked really well. Worked really, really well, but when applying the top coat, all of the little hairs got pulled out, and really messed things up. So I did a lot of sanding of the first blue top coat and reapplied it with a foam roller. These are super cheap and they work well, but this leaves a lot of air bubbles behind. And so it's really important that you do the rolling and tipping. So you roll it on and then just lightly go over it with a brush. I used odorless mineral spirits to thin it for brushing. For rolling and brushing, I use about 10% thinning, and I used MEK for spraying. It was about 15%. MEK evaporates faster, and both seem to work. There's special coatings that they want you, or special thinners that they want you to use, Interlux, particular formulas. I just went with these and they seem to work fine. I am not an expert by any means. This is my first time using this type of coating. So this is a polyurethane, one part polyurethane coating. And again, it worked out, I think, really well overall. This is just a brushed on, rolled on, rolled and tipped coat. So I think it looks pretty well, all things considered. And one thing that I used throughout the process that helped a lot was sandpaper, this door block sandpaper, these various blocks. And I went ahead, I took the plunge, and I just bought a roll of various grades, going from, I think, like 60 grit, I labeled on the inside of most of them, all the way down to 2,000, I think, at least 1,000. So it's super quick just to be able to peel off a strip and adhere it to one of the blocks, and it just makes things so much easier, so much better than trying to set up one of these blocks and getting things set on the teeth. It's just a pain. So having these makes things so much easier. Oh, you can also see my book, How to Fiberglass Boats. That's a great resource I referred to earlier, so buy that if you haven't already. if you're going to get odorless mineral spirits to thin, do not use the 65% renewable content and lower fumes variant. It just does not work as well. It's also not clear. It's white, and it's just really, it just doesn't work as well overall. So I use it for cleanup, and even then it doesn't work super well. Get the odorless mineral spirits. That's just the regular type. It can be harder to find. I got this at like my local hardware store. This is what Home Depot had. So some of the big box stores are kind of restricting what you can get there. And that's just life. I use the smaller foam rollers to get into some of the nooks and crannies, and a foam roller tray, and just a lot of regular paint supplies to mask things off. Works pretty well. So I was a little worried with using this one part polyurethane system that it'd somehow be different from regular painting, and it is to some extent. I mean, you have to thin things out, but it's really not hard to work with. And spraying it with it, again, this is something I hadn't done before. It really wasn't bad. I thinned it out 15% with the MEK, and you know, it just worked. So I didn't have to fiddle a lot with the sprayer. I was definitely worried that, you know, the primer would be too thick. I didn't have any of those issues. I used the stock 1.3 millimeter nozzle on this, and it sprayed just fine. I had a couple of boards on hand to test it out, so you know, that was one spray that obviously didn't work too well, and you know, just kept on adjusting things until I got to that type of spray pattern, which looks really nice. And you can see, so this is, I have one last top coat to do, and then this will be done. And I set up this little impromptu spray booth with just 1 mil sheeting. I just hung it up with regular spring clamps, so that was really quick and easy, and helped save the rest of my basement from getting too dirty. And just masked off what I didn't want to spray, and sprayed everything, and it just works. It works well, and I'm pretty happy with the results. So after this last coat that I apply, just gonna pull up all the plastic and masking tape, and then I'm gonna put the decking on. So again, you can see I use regular painting supplies for all of this. Really not too difficult. So I'm glad it ended up being easier than I thought it would. If you can spray on the inside instead of try to roll all this, you'll save yourself a lot of trouble. But it still can be done. I did the one coat, and it actually looked pretty good. It just took about 10 times longer. And you know, that's life if that's what you're stuck with. Luckily, I have a neighbor, and I got this nice finish as a result. So I'll keep you guys posted as we put the decking on and let you know how it goes. That's all for now. Bye.